Hi there and welcome back, fellow thinkers, friends. We are back here in Path of the Damned and Pillars of Eternity with the Renegades of Punk. We are in the Endless Paths of Ordnua, level 5, as you can see here. We've just discovered a strange pool of organs, of blood, of...
As you wish.
Anything abominable enough to be expected here. We're seeking for the master below, or for anything, really. For gold, too. And gold we may find. We've just eliminated a lot of Xoribs here. And we don't know what expects us here. It seems it could be...
I'm here.
A final fight, a boss room,
Yes? Oh?
Whatever. Well, we have rested, so...
Of course.
We are ready for whatever. Or are we? A drake. At the edge of this expansive chamber, encircled by a jabbering host of Xoribs, stands a massive reptilian creature. Its snout is spattered with the bloody remnants of a recent meal, gobbets of flesh still speared on crooked fangs. Xoribs shift anxiously, looking up expectantly at the drake as the beast stretches leathery wings in challenge, brushing the pillars to either side. Yes, yes, more sacrifice! It flaps its wings briefly and stirs up great clouds of dust. Come here, godlike. Be honored. You speak? Drake stamps one clawed foot upon the ground. I speak and stone shakes. I speak and lizards bring gold. I speak and eat well. Yes, I speak. Well, we seek the master below. So... Is Xorib sacrificed to you? Are you the master below? The master below is below. Sacrifice is not... Very smart. You think you see a section of the drake's scaled chest begin to glow orange as it laughs. Master made me lord here. Here I am king. Flames gouge from its nostrils and gaping jaws. I am god of fire and gold. All right. As you belong to the master below and want to attack us, I seem there's no diplomatic solution. So, we're definitely going to... and happily, the formation did not reset. Thank God. Because T needs to change her weapons, though. And... Kevaba is still fine. Kill the skirmisher, please. And we'll go for just a general interdiction for a start. And I think Kelvassa can go for the drake. And I want Gustine to go for the skirmisher. For the first. Just like that. Hit that drake, Adonin. Hit that drake.
Yes.
Now, what more can we do? We need a circle of protection. Something at least. We need to attack the drake with Kielbasa. Some arcane assaults will be good as well. Oh, there's a high priest here. He's going to heal up. Oh, he's also going for the... I don't think I want to attack him first. Even if he's buffing and stuff. I don't think it'll be useful. And there's a priest too. Let's attack these. quickly. Is this some kind of dazed time zone? We are frightened. We can counter that. Frighten them too. What else can we go for? We want the watchful presence, of course. The Drake is barely injured. That was to be expected. And why are our spells always stopped? The High Priest here, we have the Standard Priest. Duplicate is going for that now. Kairasa should too, because the priests are really the most dangerous ones out there. What else are we going to do? Fireballs? Is this really good? Somehow I doubt it, but we will try to slicken these. This has worked before with great success, so... And here... We'll bring down the damage reductions. Or maybe, just maybe, we should call for help. That high priest. Can attack that guy. We can hope that Adenon will attack the Drake. What more can we go for? Devotions of the Faithful. That was always not too bad, right? And Arkhamir's Dazzling Lights. Seem good. Two, on the other hand, we'd want that priest to go down. Where is the priest? I don't know. Do you see the priest? I don't see the priest anymore. Might be dead. Well, we can also just attack if we want that. Yeah, the priest is dead. Nice. That is good. There is something here. Don't know what this is. Let's see. It seems okay. Maybe it's the devotions of the faithful. And the missiles. Let's send them here. Let's attack the High Priest and instill doubt. That seems good. Why is Coral here? What the freak? Dire Blessing. Really like something out of this area of spells. Wonder over here. Then buff that. There are the champions. Skirmishers. Let's go for that, and that champion needs to die as well. Oh. He's gone down. That's tragic. Or really not. Let's go for the next Renny Derrett's ghost. Yeah. Thank you. Kebaba. We wrecking that Drake. Kill him. No, at least that. That was a good fight. A Drake Talon, sickle-shaped and impressively sharp. His talon was removed from the slain body of a Drake. And a lot of money and a skeleton here. Ylfan Buringar's Solace, a yellow shield again. Ah, nice. With preservation and exceptional. And an amulet of health.
What is it?
Well, let's look at what we found here. There's that shield. Is that here now? Oh yeah, it is here. Medium shield, 12 deflection, 50 defense while stunned and prone. 8 shield defense. Wow, this is just straightforward. Ylfan Buringar's Solace. Ylfan Buringar is not the most adept soldier. Rather, he was quite prone to stumbling over his own feet. Well aware of his failings, his family crafted him a shield of exceptional heft and durability, trusting that if he could not rain blows upon his enemies, he might at least prevent them landing any upon him in turn. The shield proved effective in this regard, for Ylfan was so thoroughly obscured by the shield, even while lying dazed in the mud, that many enemies sought out new targets out of sheer frustration. Oh, very nice. Can be, though we cannot enchant that anymore. It's just exceptional in its deflection. It has 20 deflection. Seems good. Yeah, that Sura's Summerplate has retaliation. Not too bad as well. And the larder door grants bash. You could enchant the larder door to be exceptional. What do you need for Yeah, that would need a while. The larder door is already pretty good. But it gives -8 accuracy, but it grants bash. That thing is only -4 accuracy, gives more defense while stunned and while prone. So it should really be better, right? For Adonan. Also for Vikustine. Sura's Supper Plate. The larder door. Yeah, we can just exchange that. I think that's better. Maybe we'll give the larder door over to her. 8 deflection, 16 deflection. Should be much better for tanking, and we'll enchant the larder door. Being exceptional. There we go. And now that Sura's Supper Plate here would be fit for maybe Gustine. Or maybe Kalvasa. Well, we don't need accuracy with Gustine, but with Kalvasa it is interesting at least. She has DLM Debita. So this gives dirt crushing damage, which is very sought for, so we'll give her that. which doesn't decrease her accuracy at all. Yeah, I think that's perfectly fine. And Artuk, maybe better than Shame or Glory? May it be, really? No, I don't think so. That thing? Artuk has really high accuracy. Oh, we could give it over to Vikastin. Slash damage. Artuk also has slash damage. Yeah, we believe that will be good. The Justice Sword, the Whispers of Yenwood are good. Hearth Harvest, though, even adds deflection. We don't need that anymore because we have that great shield now with her. The Shame or Glory. Maybe we want the crushing damage on her. Of course, crushing damage is so much better, and we want the Hearth Harvest on Kelvassa to give her some more deflection, just in case we need deflection on her. Yeah, I think that makes most sense. What to do with Artuk? I love my crush damage. Got to say that. Yeah, well, let's pack Artuk away.
Well?
Very nice. New shields for our tanks.
Quietly now.
As you wish.
Something hidden. Bracers of Enduring. Hands. Oh. 2 constitution, 1 resolves. Gloves, gauntlets and bracers offer a variety of benefits, and these are very good bracers. A rite of ancient legends. Increases lore. I think I want to have a look at these. Definitely. Then
well.
Let's look around a bit some more. Vague shapes of Kith are visible in the cold black ash coating the brickwork. There's something more hidden here, maybe. Something for the hands. Perception 1. There's constitution and resolve. Ah, this gives might. Constitution and resolve. Resolve perception. Constitution plus 2 and resolve plus 1. Yeah, the crit multiplier bonus. Well, screw this. We're going to give this over to Kevava. So he may live a little bit longer, maybe. I think this will help much.
Yes.
Oh, let's go down. I think we've explored everything on level 5, so let's go down to level 6. The Endless Paths of Ord Nua. This is pretty straightforward. So the plan here is to look for traps. After that is done with Kevava, we will look for enemies with Kielbasa, and there are some force crystals here. So we are expecting some Inquithan force knights, probably. This will be interesting, and we'll begin our walk into more dangerous realms in the next episode. Well, thank you for watching, fellow thinkers. Happy gaming to you. See you in the next episode. This is Immanuel Kant signing out.